knows what evil lurks in the heart of game. The Shadow Knows.
Hi, I'm The Shadow Knows, and I'm back with another Let's Compare video. Tonight I play the game Zeppelin on the Commodore 64 and the 8-bit Atari home computers. And I start with the Commodore 64 and won't torture you longer with this music. Yeah, and what I found out so far is that you fly a Zeppelin. And you get points for shooting stuff. And you can't quite control where you fly in this maze. These are switches. Not entirely sure what they do. They usually turn something on or off. Haven't quite figured out how this game works. And this is an extra life. And the Zeppelin always shoots in the direction where you fly to, but if you press, keep the fire button pressed and move the joystick into some direction, you can also shoot somewhere else. Okay. Okay. So basically you have to move all switches down. As I already said, not entirely sure what I'm supposed to do. And this is another game that I did have as a kid, and I did not like it. I have plenty of life. Ah, shit. But that's not a reason to waste them. Can I make him? No, I can't. What's... Okay. Was that something good? still not entirely sure what I am supposed to do. Okay, all switches are down. I think, yes, this is a trap. Okay, let me guess, this. This thing again. And I have to bring it to this thingy on the left again. And probably since I already destroyed almost everything. Yeah, but I think you get the point of this game. Let's have a look at the Atari version. Okay. Back with the Atari version. And as expected, the sound effects are a lot beefier than on the Commodore 64. And I find the switch is a lot harder to see. But besides that, graphics quite nice. And I do like the sound effects a lot more than on a Commodore 64. But I think the game is basically the same. Ah, shit. Ah, the switch is already down. Shit. No, it doesn't want the key, it wants this football thingy. Yeah, for some reason. I'm not sure if it's less jerky. What's that? Why is that happening? Because of this switch? Yes, because of this switch. Yeah, I would prefer a game with a little bit more action. I like shooting more than exploring. But if you're into this kind of stuff, I think you should give it a go. Yeah, I really have more problems seeing the switches on the Atari than on the Commodore 64. Level layout seems very similar on both versions. Yeah, only that the Atari version, as usual, has better sound effects. At least I like them more than the C64 sound effects. But that could just be a personal preference. Ah, shit. I should take this football, but I can't. So let's see what happens if I put this TNT into this thingy. Come on. Yeah, I think I like the Atari version a little more. Commodore 64 version feels a little... Yeah, it feels like the programmers at that point in the Commodore 64's history just weren't that familiar with it. They just had... Ah, shit. To learn how to program the Commodore 64. And they already had 2 or 3 years experience on the Atari computers. Where's the switch for that? Yeah, the switches are really much easier. No, it doesn't want TNT. Switches are much easier to identify on the Commodore 64. But besides that, I like the Atari more. Shit. Okay. That was Zeppelin on the Commodore 64 and the Atari. I hope you enjoyed this video and thanks for watching.